Hello, and welcome back to another Somax2 tutorial. I'm Marco Fiorini from the music representation team at Ircam, and today we're gonna dive deep into the real Max style of Somax2. This is because, as I previously said, with this new distribution, the 2.5 Somax comes both as a Max application, as we saw in the previous tutorials, but also as a library of Max abstractions that you can really use in your Max programming workflow. So again, from the overview, which I remind you is contained in the root folder or the extras folder, and so it's available also on the extras menu of Max, we have a tab that says Max tutorials, and you can see these are 7 tutorials, but actually there's more because each tutorial has multiple tabs sometimes to cover audio and MIDI. And these tutorials are incremental in terms of complexity and depth. So I strongly encourage you to follow the order of the tutorials, and because of this, we will not be able to cover all of them, but I rather show you the basic workflow, which resembles a lot to what we already saw in the first 2 application tutorials. So let's dive into it. Basic workflow. The first thing we might notice is that the terminal window now popped up automatically. And this is because in the Max version, both the server and the player that I remind you communicate with a remote counterpart on Python, they are automatically initialized unless you don't create them with the auto initialize zero attribute. So in the tutorials, we prefer to have them automatically initialized for you, but we also give you this information. So you see we have a server initialized and 3 different players which are contained around dispatchers. So as a workflow reminder, we here have all the different sections and modules that we already saw in the application version. So we have a corpus, which is the musical material that it's loaded into a player. And this corpus is created, is built by an audio corpus builder or a MIDI corpus builder. As we saw in the last video, we created an audio corpus. So the corpus is actually the material that the player uses to perform. And then we have the influences that are handled by the influencers. So we have either a audio or a MIDI input stream, and these are converted, thanks to the influencers, in influences, which are actually labeled segments according to onset, pitch, and chroma, that are sent to the player as triggers. So the player knows a certain material, which is the corpus, and listens to certain influences, which can be taken from your live input playing or from an audio file. And according to the matches that it finds between the influences and the corpus, responds, okay? So the player, of course, communicates with the server, and differently from the application version where the player was actually outputting either MIDI or audio, that was because the application module is a big module that has a lot of utility tools for you to be ready to play just with them. The core object, so the Max object, doesn't play back audio or MIDI, but rather it sends out streams of data, and you have to take care of this data. But we provided also some renderers for playback of MIDI and audio, so you can also use the default Somax renderers, as we are showing here, or you can build your own rendering system. So let's move to the basic audio interaction. So what you see here, it's nothing more than a server, a player, and an influencer. But of course, it's all patched in Max style, so we'll have to break it up a little bit. So first of all, as I said, both server and players are automatically influenced unless you don't send, you don't create them with the auto initialize zero attribute. So from the second outlet of both the server and the player, you can monitor the status. The server, in this case, you will see that the message that comes out is one ready. So we are using both a message to read the full status and a toggle to see when it's one. So this is going to be active. And the player is going to send one or zero. And if it's one, so we will light up this toggle, it means that the player is initialized on the server. So we can see that we have a server initialized, it's ready, and the player initialized. If, for instance, the player wouldn't have been initialized automatically, you can send to the server the initialized player's message that will initialize all the players, or you can directly send to the player the initialized message. So, first of all, let's load a corpus into it. And this is done by sending the message corpus followed by the name of the corpus. And you will see that now here we received as an output the corpus that has been loaded. So we just need to send the name of the audio file, or rather of the segmented file, because .pickle is the extension of segmented audio corpus. But this is, of course, because this is part of the distributed corpus. When you are going to send your own corpus, you want to use an absolute path or change the corpus path, which is the folder where all the corpus are contained and read from the player. And the player, as I told you, is not outputting audio, but it's outputting data. In this case, we're going to use an audio renderer because we are using an audio corpus. So remember that the renderer has always to match the kind of corpus that you are loading. So we are loading an audio corpus, we are using an audio renderer, okay? But we can also query whatever is coming out of the corpus of the player. So in this case, we are asking to route when we receive the corpus. You see that now we receive this corpus. Influences. In this case, we're going to use an audio influencer, which is this one, and the data that's coming out of the influencer has to be prepended with the word influence and then sent directly to the player. So the audio stream, in this case, we provided the choice between a live stream, live input of your sound card, or an audio file that you can put into this playlist. We're going to select the audio file. This is going to come out as a monitor reference here, but it's going to be also sent to the audio influencer that will analyze, will segment it and analyze it, and then will convert it into influences for the player. So now we are ready to go, and if we run the server and we start our influence, our live stream, the player is gonna reply to it. And of course, if we stop the playback of the influence, also the player is gonna stop. So this was the basic behavior of an audio configuration. We used both an audio influencer and an audio corpus. Let's move now to MIDI. And remember, this is highly important. You don't want to allocate multiple servers, okay? Because you see here that server has a status, and if you create multiple servers, one of these is going to be the status duplicate. Because of course the server is the object that basically open the stream of communication with the remote backend of the application, which is in Python, and so only one server is needed at each time. So don't instantiate, as good habit, don't instantiate multiple servers, otherwise you're going to have only one true active servers, and all the other ones are going to be duplicates. So if you have patches, many open patches with a lot of server, it might be difficult for you to go into which one was the original one, and then you have to close everything and reload the server, because otherwise it won't work. So in the tutorials we are taking care of this for you. So this is the only true server, and what you see here, it's actually a monitoring of the server contained in the other tab. So if you remember from the application tutorials, we then built a corpus based on your material, but also we tweaked some parameters, and we can of course do this as well in Max. So in the second tutorial we're going to introduce some parameters. There are, of course, a lot of parameters, and if you go to the help center, you're gonna have help files for any object in Somax. And if you, for example, if you open the player Max help, you will notice that there is a whole set of messages that you can send to it to control it, okay? So we are just using, we are just actually introducing some of them. But again, go through all the tutorials to have also a further interaction with the parameters and explore the help centers thanks to the overview to really have a wide spectrum of all the content in Somax. So back to our introducing parameters. Again, the server has been launched, and you can see again that the tutorial, the terminal has been opened automatically, and we have one server and one player instantiated. So here's the server, which is running, and here's the player, which is ready. So what we're going to do in this case, we're going to load an audio corpus. Okay, so we're going to need an audio renderer as an output, but then we're going to use a MIDI influencer as an influencer, because it doesn't mean that an audio corpus has to be influenced by audio influences and a MIDI corpus by MIDI influences. You can really mix them up as you want, okay, as also we saw in the application tutorials. So we're going to load the corpus, and you will notice here that now the corpus has been loaded, and we're gonna run the server, play some notes on the MIDI keyboard, and you will hear a guitar corpus in reaction. That's me. An important thing that we added here is the monitoring of the current index and the matches. So if you recall from the application player, you have modules showing different stuff. And here again, you have to root everything. So in this case, here we are matching the last played event of the corpus. So when we stopped, the player had already finished to play event number 14. And here we also see the matches of the different descriptors of the different layers. So the player basically generate its output by listening to influences and finding matches between the influences and the corpus based on different layers of parameters. So we have melodic, both internal, meaning its own feedback, and external influences, the ones coming from the influencers, and harmonic influences. So again, internal and external. And this white one is the total matches that it's finding. So let's take a look at this little number here, because now we are gonna look at the playing mode and the continuity as we saw in the application tutorial. So by default, the player is in reactive mode. We see now the server is running, there is no influence coming, and the player is not playing anything. But if we put the player in continuous mode, it will play back without the need of any influence as an input. And as we see here, the player is really just playing the corpus linearly, one slice after the other, and you can also hear it. What it's been playing is really coherent, okay? So you see that every time the number is increasing. But we can change this continuity using this parameter. So this is actually a bias. If the continuity is at 1, the corpus is going to be played linearly, But if this is lower than 1, we have jumps in the corpus. So let's look at this number here again. And you saw it was around 80 and now it's around 20, because I really lower the continuity from 1 to 0.2. If I set, for instance, a very high continuity, it's gonna become again continuous. And you see, it's now playing the slices one after the other. Let's bring it back to a very low value, and you'll notice wide jumps. So, again, you can have a more depth overview of all these tutorials, of all these parameters in the following tutorials, but what I really wanted to show you is that you can, thanks to the Max library, you can also merge and use a combination of the different objects. So again, the terminal pops up and you see we have the server and we have two players created. But at first glance, you might notice here that we have some Max style objects and some objects that reminds us of the application objects. And in fact, there are certain objects like the player or the influencers that has three version of it, which is the Max like, the application like, and the user interface. So here we are actually using, as you see, an audio influencer UI, which stands for user interface, and a player UI. And the difference between those is that the Max version, so the Somax.player, for instance, it's really the core object, the basic Max object. The player.ui, as this one, it's exactly the same as the core object, but with a user interface. But it doesn't have to be confused with the .app, because the .app object is a fully operative application object, which takes care of a whole lot of stuff, like the routing of the incoming influences, the playing back of the output, just to name a few. So you see here that in this case, we are using a user interface, but still we need to send the influence and we need to render the audio output. So it's not automatically done and ready as the application one. But it's very handy when you want, for instance, to control player, which has a wide set of parameters. Okay, as we saw before, you can of course script the player using messages, but if you want to really interact in real time, the user interface is very nice because it gives you the whole array of parameters. So again, we have the server, which is ready. We have this player, which is initialized, and we need to load it with a corpus. And remember, this one is not the application object, so you need to be consistent with the kind of corpus that you use and the renderer. So here I put an audio renderer, so we're gonna load an audio corpus. And you can recognize them because you have A for audio corpus and M for MIDI corpus. So for instance, let's load this audio corpus. And once it's loaded, the button here, the light is green, and you see that the player is enabled. You also have, through the settings button, the whole set of settings of the player, which is the same of the player app. This part is really the central part of the whole player app. And here you have like the really main interaction parameters, where here you have a whole set of parameters, but let's play just with the basic ones for the moment. So we're going to use again an audio file as an influence, and here you will see that we have the audio influencer UI. So also here we have a settings button that will let you select the kind of onset detection and all the different parameters that you can play with, as well as giving a visual reference. So what we'll play here will have a reference in terms of onset, pitch, and chroma. And now if we run the server and we play, the player is going to respond to what we are playing. And we can control it from here, okay? We can have increase the continuity. Lower the continuity. Or put it in continuous mode. The same style, we can have MIDI player. So again, in this case, we are using a player.ui user interface, so we have to take care of the fact that we are using a MIDI renderer, and thus we need a MIDI corpus. Let's put, for instance, this Bach invention. Let's run the server. Oh, sorry, we had still enabled this player. Remember that we only have one server per patch, so if this player is enabled and it was in continuous mode, it will be playing. So we can disable it, go back here, run this server, and for instance, if we put this in continuous mode, it will be playing Bach First Invention. But if we put it in reactive, it will respond to the upcoming influence, and you can tweak all the parameters from here. So to conclude this kind of merge between the different objects, let's take a look at the last tutorial, which is really showing you that you have these two players. Let's start the server first, and you should see that you have this audio player and this my audio player. And at first glance, you might not see any difference. They really look almost identical to me. But then, if you go out of presentation mode, you can see that this one is an application player, so it's a player.app, while the other one was composed by all the different UI version of the object. So here you see that what a player app does is it takes a player, so remember that the player UI, it's actually the basic, the core version of the player, but enhanced with a user interface. It takes this one here, but it provides also a module for routing of the influences. It provides a renderer, which has also an audio influencer, which is this module here, and some output modules, okay, so these audio mixer and audio output, which are all combined here. But here you can see that really, if you connect them in this order, they really look the same. And actually, let's, for instance, put a couple of corpora here and there. You can see that they are completely completely operative, and for instance, let's put the my audio player as an influence for the audio player, and let's put this in continuous mode. Audio player. So you can see that it's really an identical operating object, but it's compound, okay, composed of different modules. The same applies for MIDI, because the application player, it's actually generic, okay? You should see here, this looks exactly the same as this other one. But once we load a MIDI corpus into it, this lower part changes. and it becomes actually a MIDI renderer with a MIDI output module. So this is the handy thing of the app objects. They are taking care of many different stuff, and they are providing actually some utilities for you to just worry about playing. And they are also wireless. You see, we are actually sending influences between players without connecting patch cords. But here again, if you get out of presentation mode, you will have the same configuration as we had in the first tab. But here at the output of the player, we have to specify that we have a MIDI renderer and MIDI output modules. So it's really important here you load a MIDI corpus, because otherwise this player won't work. While this one, the application player, can adapt to any kind of corpus. So again, we load an audio corpus and this becomes an audio output module. So this should prove the, should show you the modularity of Somax2, which, as I told you, works very well either in application mode or Max-like mode, depending on your very needs. And remember, go through the Max tutorials for deep information about all these parameters, and most importantly, go also to the Help Center, where you can find really helpful Max helps for any kind of object. So for instance, for the player object, which is the Max-like version, or for the player app, which is the application version. And here you will see all the modules, all the different versions that you can have of the player, as well as all the parameters well explained here. So thank you for watching, and to the next tutorial.